Hi, somebody requested for me to react to this video in particular. It's called 10 Most Dangerous Waters in the World. Okay. Let's.
The world is 70% water, so it's probably a good thing that the stuff is good for us. We can drink it, swim in it, grow food with it, and just plain live because of it. However, certain bodies of water are shockingly hostile to us. Interacting with some lakes and rivers can hurt us, make us sick, or even kill us. Hello, guys, and today we're talking about 10 bodies of water that want you dead. Before we begin, we'd like you to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications. All right, number 10. Boiling Lake Dominica. Whoever named this place was certainly no fan of subtlety. Boiling Lake is exactly what it sounds like. Discovered in 1870 by two Englishmen, temperatures taken 5 years later ranged anywhere from 82 to 91.5 degrees centigrade. While certainly that's hot enough to peel skin, those temperatures were only recorded around the edges of the lake. The center is far, far hotter, to the point where an accurate measurement cannot be taken, lest the guy with the thermometer get boiled alive. The theory is that Boiling Lake sits on top of a bunch of molten lava, and the gases shoot up into the water, heating it to a monstrous degree. Number 9. Sitaram River, West Java, Indonesia. Here we have a body of water that can destroy us, but only because we screwed it up. Sitaram River might well be the most polluted, trash-filled bit of water on the planet. Thanks to more than 500 factories that line the river, plus the area's lack of trash collection or modern plumbing, the river has filled with waste and rubbish to the point where you can barely see the water. And this is the area's main water supply.
This looks like in the Philippines, oh my gosh. Sorry, but it's reality. I've seen this before. I used to be one of those kids playing around. Great childhood.
Locals use this river for drinking, bathing, and even boiling food. Suffice to say, they put their health and lives on the line every time. But sadly, they don't have a choice. Number 8. River Tinto, Spain. River Tinto is among the most acidic bodies of water around, with a pH balance of 2 at best. This means the River Tinto is as strong as stomach acid, and is more than powerful enough to kill any fish that dare swim in it. More likely, it would do the same to humans. River Tinto's acid trip is caused by bacteria, as well as iron that has dissolved into the water over the many years. Similar occurrences have been found on Mars, prompting scientists to wonder if River Tinto has something to offer in the quest for life on the red planet. While that may be a pipe dream based on both places being red, there's no question that, much like an angry grizzly bear, River Tinto is both beautiful and something you should never touch. Number 7. Lake Kivu of DRC and Rwanda. 300 meters, 1,000 feet below the surface of Lake Kivu lies a ticking time bomb. Over 250 cubic kilometers, that's 60 cubic miles, of carbon dioxide, along with around 65 cubic kilometers, that's 15 cubic miles, of methane gas, lurks under this body of water, enough to provide electricity to several countries. Problem is, it's also enough to flood every nearby settlement, killing thousands in the process. Right now, all those gases are dormant, but all it would take is one volcanic eruption. And with the many volcanoes nearby, that's always a possibility. and the gases would rush to the top, resulting in massive destruction for the area. Number 6. The rivers of Johannesburg, South Africa. Catching E. coli is no fun under normal circumstances. Now imagine you were literally swimming in the stuff. That's the reality around various rivers in Johannesburg, South Africa, where the amount of E. coli bacteria in the water is way beyond acceptable levels. Some areas, like the nearby Cheetah Bridge, host 240 times more E. coli than what is considered healthy. The more fit and trim areas, such as Kelspruit, only exceed the healthy limit by 190 times. Number 5. Blackwater River, Virginia, USA. Too much water can be a bad thing, even if the water can't kill you otherwise. Just ask the folks around Blackwater River in Virginia, who have seen the waters rise and attack far more than usual these past few years. After close to 60 years of normalcy, the Blackwater River has overflowed and flooded nearby towns 6 times in the past 10 years. No deaths have been reported, but it seems to be a matter of time before one is, unless the river is calmed down somehow. Number 4. Tualatin River, Oregon, USA. Oregon's Tualatin River is not the place to be if you want to take your dogs for a swim. Close to a dozen pups die there every year from exposure to toxic blue-green algae. Actually a deadly form of bacteria, algae can grow fast, quickly polluting a body of water in a deceptively pretty shade of turquoise. Those unfortunate enough to swallow the stuff can expect sickness and diarrhea at best, paralysis and death at worst. Number 3. Lake Karachay, Russia. Like a supermodel with a bomb strapped underneath her bodice, Russia's Lake Karachay is pristine, gorgeous, and incredibly deadly. That is, without question, the most radioactive body of water on the planet. A major dumping ground for nuclear waste until the 90s, Karachay's toxicity was so bad that, for a long time, you didn't even have to touch the water for it to kill you. Simply standing on the shore for an hour or so would bombard you with 600 roentgen of radiation. Most human dies from 500 roentgen over 5 hours, for comparison's sake. Number 2. Belle Fourche River in South Dakota, USA. Belle Fourche isn't poisonous, boiling, or radioactive. However, it is turbulent and wild, at least in one particular area. Authorities near the river's diversion dam want a mile-long area closed to the public, now that several deaths have been reported there. In 2010, a father, his young daughter, and their friend drowned after raging rapids knocked them out of their boat and trapped them underwater. And finally, number 1. The Potomac River, Maryland, West Virginia border, USA. Though the only thing most people know about the Potomac is that Washington, D.C. is situated on it, the legendary river can also be associated with something else. Horrible deaths. The area between Great Falls and Chain Bridge forms a series of rapids and waterfalls that send their victims spiraling downward for almost an entire 1.5 kilometers. That's over a mile. If that's not enough, the river's strongest currents are actually underwater. So if you get sucked down, you stay down. Around 6 people die each year at the Potomac, and many more risk their lives simply by playing near or around it. Thank you for watching. Does anyone want to come over and swim with me? Write in the comments what you think of these bodies of water.
Oh my gosh, this is such a great video, giving people knowledge on those rivers, whether here in the US or some parts all the worlds, and it's very interesting. It's an eye opener to me I thought I was just watching some parts of the world where it depicts like just a scenario back home in my country in the Philippines, but this is also very interesting. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you guys amazed how I was all in awe. I was jaw dropping watching these rivers, and it's great to know. This has been Reggie. Thank you so much for watching, and have a wonderful evening. Be safe, everyone. See you later. Oops, I burped.